Hello everyone. The 2021 World Robot Conference opened at September 10th in Beijing. And now I am standing in front of the exhibition hall. This year's WRC includes the forums, the exhibition, and the robot competition. So now just follow us to know more about the details. First of all, we invite the staff of the WRC, Sarah Yang, to give us an introduction. Hello, Sarah.
Hello.
Say hi to everyone.
Hello, everyone.
So now, would you mind to give us a short introduction about this year's WRC?
Okay. Actually, this year's WRC is theme is actually to inject momentum to this industry and shared results for building a win-win and collaborative society. And this year's forum, we have adopted the brand new structure of Navigator Conference, a future conference, and an international conference. And this international conference has already been held today because those foreign guests are online. And tomorrow we will hold the Navigators Conference, and the day after tomorrow we will have this future conference. So apart from these main forums, we also hold exhibitions. So this year we have attracted 100 enterprises who have brought about 500 products to this exhibition halls. And these exhibition halls can be divided into three parts. The exhibition hall A is mainly for the industrial robot. Exhibition hall B is for the service robots, and C for specialized robots. What's more, we also have those competitions. We have competitions for the BCI, the brain computer interface, and also have those use competitions and the robot application competitions and the tree collaboration competitions. So these are about the main forum and also the competition as well as our exhibition.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Thank you, Sarah.
Pleasure.
Okay.
Thank you.
So now maybe we can go into the hall to see about the exhibition. And so just like everybody knows, the robots now have been already involved with our real life, especially in the manufacturing industry. So in the hall, we can see many companies to show their newest type of industrial robots. So just like this one, the Xiunan. So maybe we can find someone to give us an introduction.
So, hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
May I know your name?
Yeah, let's call me Fei.
Yeah.
So hello everyone, welcome to the Xinhua exhibition sections. So today we're going to introduce you guys one of our famous projects, which is called Digital Factory.
Yeah. So maybe you can give us a
okay.
Demo.
So this is our Xinhua high-end technology server, a digital flat. It's totally different from what we have seen from the previous exhibitions, and it basically have five light spots. So to begin with, it was totally constructed on a practical user condition of Xinhua Xiunan server, which means that it's an existence and completely digital factory project instead of just a simple exhibition section. And secondly, the factory is created based on industrial software and control platform. Because they're all Xinhua's products, from the range of software to the hardware. And this shows the autonomous and controllable spatiality of our whole system, from the bottom to top. It's not only solved the problem of lack of chips and brain, but also guarantees the safety of industrial information as well. So just make sure we're on the same page. The brain means our central control system. Okay, so let's continue to the third light spot. Our factory applies digital twinning technology, which means before the deployment of the production line, it can simulate and optimize the future operation condition of production line via digital scenes in advance. So it can adjust to the best condition then deploy, and which perfectly solved the most severe problem of 3C trees, fast interaction speed and long market cycle. And to the fourth, this is the first large-scale deployment robot of high-end server area. So it entirely makes the flexible manufacturing compute. So as we all know, the cost of components and parts of server industry are extremely high. So we're all afraid of damage of work pieces. So in this case, Samsung's cobots, mobile robots, and hybrid robots are all deployed with Sense systems. So they are able to be mobilized unitedly. And they apply the working mode with the simulations of hands, feet, eyes, and feelings of human beings, which extremely improves the precision and the flexibility of the work. So finally, it combines the customized design and the product's modularity. So at the moment, so we can hear from a lot of companies that they emphasize the ability of customize the design. Well, we focus on the modularizations and the standardizations of warehouse systems, and sorting stations, the maintenance stations, and other sections on top of that. So it enables us to apply any stations and the production lines based on the user's capacity requirements. So in addition, we can even quickly duplicate the whole digital platform, the quick duplication of the whole digital platform.
Cool, that's amazing. And also I can see that there are some robots just look like snakes. So maybe we can, yeah, here. This one is also a robot or something?
These two robots are extremely cool. So these are called Dragon Theory snake-like robots.
Dragon.
Yes, Dragon Theory. So on this exhibition, we display both a vertical type and horizontal type snake-like robots. So this is our horizontal type snake-like robot. So it's a display the foreign matters detection and cleaning work in the aircraft wind tank. And it's already applied and approved on our domestic C919 aircraft types and other large aircraft types.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Ms. Zhang. Thank you very much. So despite those huge robots and the mechanical arms they're using into the manufacturing line, some robots may look not like a robot, but they can still help us. Just like some wearable devices. And we can see this company, they have some newest wearable devices that can help us. So, yeah, this one. Mr. Zhang, hi. Hi, so would you mind to give us an introduction of your product?
Okay, thank you.
So maybe you can just say hi
first. Hi everybody. Yeah. I'm Lei Jiang, associate professor of China Chinese University of Mining and Technology and the CTO of the Chinese exoskeleton company. Yeah.
Would you mind to give us some introduction of your product? Cause I can see the wearable devices here.
Mostly we have like 3 to 4 types of exoskeleton robot. Yeah, this is the electrical powered exoskeleton robot. If you wear this exoskeleton robot, you can this robot can provide more power and more torque to you. And in one side, you can like lift the more weight.
So maybe we can find someone to try it on.
Excuse me, do you like try maybe, to show this?
Okay. So this is just a wearable device.
Always like when you warehouse, you know warehouse, the warehouse workers they need to use their self power to lift the weight things certain times one day. This kind of work will damage their back. Yeah, you know the back stress will be very big, very very huge. Yeah, if you wear this robot device, they can protect your back and provide more power. And this time, we always like balance the power output and the weight. You know, if the exoskeleton robot is very heavy, if you wear it, you feel very, you cannot like wear this kind of robot all day, but we try to minimize the weight of the robot and increase the power of the robot. Compared to the international company's product, this product is very, very light and provide more power.
I can see it's very easy to wear it.
Since our motor is very very powerful and is made in China, not like made in USA or made in Japan. And we designed the FOC controller for the power to increase the efficiency of the motor and decrease the weight. So this is kind of balanced. If you can have both.
Now they wear it and
clothes. They can like the robot can provide the how to say the lifting power from these gloves. And the sensor can detect your intention of working. If you want to lift something, the sensor, you don't need like use any like a button, any switch to tell the robot I want to lift something. We use the algorithm and the sensor to detect the gate automatically. If the computer find you want to lift something, here we are like increase the power and the provide the lifting force.
How heavy is it?
How heavy for the robot? I think it's like 30 kilograms or 30 kilograms. This is easily, this is just 24 bottles of the beer. It's not a servo motor.
Excuse me, how do 你刚才觉得你穿着它去这个抬这些东西的时候感受是怎么样？是很轻松吗？还是
很轻松，
比较轻松的。
对，那个整个的力会卸在这个袋子上，所以我的手臂是不用太用力的，它就可以上来。我的腰部也不用太多的用力，因为它给我腿部跟臀部有一个支撑，就会。
So he says he feels very easy to lift all of these things because his, you can see that his arms actually are not heavy. So for him, this the lifting is very easy now. So his arms don't feel that with too much pressure. So the wearable devices just makes him stronger than he is. Mr. Jiang, do all these wearable devices now used into the real life?
Yeah, warehouse, yeah. We have already sold around like 60 robots to Jingdong company. You know, the Jingdong company, there are so many like warehouse. They have so many like workers in warehouse. Because they are warehouse, they don't own the land of the warehouse, so they cannot like implement automatically like a transportation line. So they still need many workers to lift every day.
Yeah.
So they bought 60 robots to help their staff to work efficiently and healthily.
Oh.
Yeah.
So I can see also that. This is the prototype.
We just want to use this to justify the pneumatic driving robot. These two robots are driven by the electric power, but this one is driven by the pneumatic power. Pneumatic power can provide more like more power than the electric power, but they need some like kind of like power pump. You need a pump, yeah, and you need a line to connect the pump and the robot to provide the force, yeah. So, and this is so cool, yes. This is our dreamer robot. It's not like a business, yeah, just a prototype.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you. The robots now are not only applied into the manufacturing industry, but also come into our daily life. The commercial robots now become our new friends. With their help, we can have a better life. And this company, the Terminus, is one of those providers of those kind of robots. And now we can take a look. Hi. So maybe you can give us a short introduction of yourself now.
Okay, thank you. Hi, everyone. I'm Sun Yun. I'm the Senior Vice President of Terminus Technology, and Terminus Technology is the Chinese leading artificial intelligence and Internet of Things technology company. We are providing the solutions for AI City, and we also have our Super Terminus End project. This is our robots called Titan Planet Robots. This is the mascot robot of Dubai Expo. So you can see we design it from a 2D cartoon character from a drawing. It spent like only 6 months to build from a drawing sketch up and to really make it become a real robot. It already can dance, it can do the parade. So we are giving Expo 50 units. So it's going to do the parade and the group dancing during the opening ceremony of Dubai Expo 2020 in October. So it's very popular. Everybody love it.
Yeah. So it's very cute. And it seems like that we can interact with it or something.
Yeah, of course. I can show you now.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. Actually, I have an APP. You can see it. I have using a control panel, so you can see that we can do a a different facial expression. So there is a lot of tourists and visitors getting to interact with our mascot. So it has a different pose. You can take a picture with it. Yeah, the pose. Yeah, you have like facial expressions like singing. Yeah, like crying, and they can solo dance, let's say. Let's give it to some space. It can do a solo dance.
Yeah.
Because maybe there's so many people around it, it cannot move too much. Yeah, solo dance one. So right now it's very cute. It's going to like have some interactions with visitors and enhance the experience.
Yeah.
So thank you, Ms. Lance. Thank you.
And now many robots are serving in the restaurants now. So maybe we can find another company like this one, the Xinhua. Yeah, they focus on the robots that serving in the restaurants. So maybe you can find someone to introduce it. Hi. Hello, this is Mr. Jiang. Maybe you can say hi to everyone.
Oh, hi, hello everyone.
About your products?
Yeah, of course. We are Xinhua Robotics, and we are experts of commercial service robots. And for example, this one is a delivery robot. And for example, our company provides online delivery in catering and hotels and other commercial fields. And this one is also a delivery robot.
This one?
Yeah, this is a little one. As a matter of fact, we have developed many kind of delivery robots to use in different fields and different scenarios. For example, this one is bigger, so it can use in the big restaurant.
This one?
No, I mean this one.
Oh, the three one.
Yeah, maybe in the restaurant more than 400 square meters, and this one and that one is the little one in the usually work in the small restaurant. Yes. During the epic period, we also deliver food and other medical stuff in the hotels. So we also develop this medical delivery robot. Yeah, mainly used
for medical use.
Yes, mainly used in hospitals.
Oh. Yeah. So you sell this one to the other country, or?
Yes. Although the China is, you know, the epic period has passed, but in the foreign countries, they are still very serious. Yeah. Currently, I think American and Dubai has, we have sold more than hundreds of delivery robots. Yes. Yes, we have many lasers, such as LiDAR lasers and deep vision, touch sensors. Yes, we have many sensors to equipped in our robots, so they can move freely in the restaurant and other complex environment. Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Since the robots become part of our lives, so maybe we can know more about it. So just focus on the WRC and we will know more different types of robots. And thank you for all.